The Charge of the Light Brigade. By Alfred Lord Tennyson, author. Alfred Tennyson, 1st Baron Tennyson, August 6, 1809, October 6, 1892, was a British poet. He was the poet laureate during much of Queen Victoria's reign and remains one of the most popular British poets. In 1829, Tennyson was awarded the Chancellor's Gold Medal at Cambridge for one of his first pieces, Timbuktu. He published his first solo collection of poems, chiefly lyrical, in 1830. Clara Bell and Mariana, which remain some of Tennyson's most celebrated poems, were included in this volume. Introduction. Alfred Lord Tennyson wrote The Charge of the Light Brigade in response to a battle wherein the British cavalry charged over open terrain in the Battle of Balaclava in the Crimean War. With 637 men, the British charged against Russia in what Alfred Lord Tennyson saw as a suicidal charge. At the time, Russia sought to control the Dardanelles, which would have threatened British sea routes. This particular war became well known because of Florence Nightingale, who nursed wounded soldiers during this war. Stanza 1. Half a league, half a league, half a league onward. All in the valley of death. Road to 600. Forward, the Light Brigade. Charge for the guns, he said. Into the valley of death. Road to 600. Explanation. The speaker reveals the subject of the Charge of the Light Brigade, which is the 600 men who rode to their deaths. He claims that they were marching straight into the valley of death. The valley of death, of course, is a biblical reference to Psalm 23. This could perhaps offer hope because Psalm 23 states, "Yeah, though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I will fear no evil, for you are with me." The speaker suggests that the men knew that they were marching to their deaths. However, by referring to the place as the valley of death, he also suggests that the men took comfort in knowing that their God was with them, even as they marched to their deaths. Stanza 2. Forward, the Light Brigade. Was there a man dismayed? Not though the soldier knew. Someone had blundered. There's not to make reply. There's not to reason why. There's but to do and die. Into the valley of death. Road to 600. Explanation. With the stanza of the Charge of the Light Brigade, the speaker reveals the thoughts of the soldiers as they marched on. Though they knew that someone had made a mistake that would cost them all their lives, they pressed onward anyway, to do the duty that they came to do. They did not think that it was their place to respond to the mistake that was made, nor to even try to reason through why they were marching to sure deaths. Rather, they simply saw it as their duty to follow commands and to do what they came to do. Stanza 3. Cannon to right of them. Cannon to left of them. Cannon in front of them. Volleyed and thundered. Stormed at with shot and shell. Boldly they rode and well. Into the jaws of death. Into the mouth of hell. Road to 600. Explanation. The speaker attests to their boldness as they rode into the mouth of hell. He speaks as one who was there and saw it all. The man knew that they were trapped. There were cannons on all sides of them, but still, they rode into the battle, and the speaker says that they rode well. The reader can imagine the brave young men, riding with their heads held high into a battle they were sure to lose. The 600 men rode into the jaws of death with the proud valor of soldiers willing to die for their country. Stanza 4. Flashed all their sabers bare. Flashed as they turned in air. Sabering the gunners there. Charging an army, while all the world wondered. Plunged in the battery smoke. Right through the line they broke. Cossack and Russian. Reeled from the saber stroke. Shattered and sundered. Then they rode back, but not the 600. Explanation. The speaker reveals that while this army of 600 charged to their deaths, the rest of the world wondered why they were ordered into that death trap. The only people not wondering were the soldiers themselves, who simply knew that it was their duty to go to battle, though most were sure to die. At the end of this stanza of the charge of the Light Brigade, the speaker reveals that some did make it out alive. These were the ones who rode back. However, he clarifies that it was not the 600 who returned. He does not reveal how many made it out alive, but history reveals that 247 of the men returned home from that battle. Stanza 5. Cannon to right of them. Cannon to left of them. Cannon behind them. Volleyed and thundered. Stormed at with shot and shell. While horse and hero fell. They that had fought so well. Came through the jaws of death. Back from the mouth of hell. All that was left of them. Left of 600. Explanation. The speaker again states that there were cannons on all sides of these men and that both horse and hero fell. He again attests to their bravery, saying that they had fought so well. He says that they came through the jaws of death and back from the mouth of hell. The speaker clearly finds it miraculous that 247 of the men lived through the battle. Stanza 6. When can their glory fade? Oh, the wild charge they made. All the world wondered. Honor the charge they made. Honor the Light Brigade. Noble 600. Explanation. The speaker calls to honor the 600 men who marched with the Light Brigade at the Battle of Balaclava. He asks the rhetorical question, when can their glory fade? Suggesting that they would be forever remembered for their honor in marching so bravely into the valley of death. The speaker repeats, all the world wondered, causing readers from all generations to understand the intensity of the danger they faced. The whole world knew that it was a death trap, and they all wondered why they were sent to fight. The speaker calls for the honor of the noble 600. The purpose of the charge of the Light Brigade is to remind readers of generations of the honor and glory of the men who marched into the battle. The speaker honors the dead and the living of the 600. He calls for the honor of them all for the sacrifice they made in boldly marching into a battle where many were sure to die.